Hey everyone, this is John Dickinson, here to share with you the new features and enhancements included with Sapphire Builder in Sapphire version 2023.5. Let's take a look. Finding an effect in Sapphire and adding it into the workspace is now faster thanks to a couple of new options, and the first is Favorites. Notice over here in the effects list, there's a new Favorites category. If I twirl that open, you can see I've got a few favorites in there. These are some of the effects that I use to create a couple of the new presets. And if we want to add an effect to that list, we just do a search, type in the first few letters, say vignette, and click on the star, and twirl open favorites again, and there it is in the list. To add that into the workspace, we just double click, and there it is in the workspace. I'm just going to quickly delete that. And to remove it from the favorites list, just uncheck the star. So that's the first way to find effects, definitely faster than before. But there's an even faster way, and that's by using the new Effect Quick menu. So once again, with source selected, I'm just going to hit the tab key. And that brings up the menu. All I have to do is type in the first few letters, hit enter, and that's now been added into the workspace. So it's super fast. Let's add another one. Tab. Maybe some ultra grain. If there's a few in the list, I can just double click the one I want, and that adds that into the workspace. So, a couple of great new features for finding effects more quickly in Sapphire Builder in 2023.5. The biggest feature in this version, though, is parameter linking. And parameter linking allows you to control parameters by linking them together. Let's build a simple example. And what I want to do is create a tilt shift effect using vignette, but control the effect using just the opacity parameter. So I'm going to delete ultra grain, and with vignette one selected, there's the opacity parameter. And over to the right here, you can see there's a stopwatch. So this is a new icon. This used to be a little graph. And if I click on that, this will reveal the animation settings, which you may be familiar with. But there's also a couple of new options in there. There's this make driver option, and this one here, toggle parameter linking. We'll look at that one in a moment, but what we want to do is have opacity be the driver. So I'm going to click make driver. And when I do that, you can see the word opacity turns green. So this is now ready to be linked to other parameters. So I'm going to just close that up now. And the first thing I want to control is blur amount. So I'll reveal the controls. And this time I'm going to click on that link. And notice how the text blur amount turns red. And beneath that, there's a few options here. The one I'm interested in right now is selecting the driver. So I'm going to click, and there's my vignette one opacity. And that's there because we made opacity a driver. So when I click that, the blur amount itself becomes unselectable. I can't change that parameter because that's now being driven by opacity. So watch over here. If I change the opacity value, the blur decreases and increases. And you can see how the slider for blur amount is changing as well. All right, so that's the start. Let's now link rel height. So once again, I'm going to reveal the controls, click on the link, select the driver, opacity, and if I just roll out here a little bit, if I change opacity, watch how the rel height increases. So I don't want that. I want to reverse that. So what I can do is I can adjust the offset and scale. So to reverse it, I'm going to set offset to 1, and I'm going to set scale to -1. Aha. Now it's a little small, so I might just stretch it out. So this is rel width. I can just use the HUD here and just stretch that out like that. And now if I change opacity, this will scale in the direction that I want. There we go. So as I increase the opacity, that closes up. Very nice. But of course, we're not limited to linking parameters of the same effect. We can also link to parameters of other effects. So let's add some grain to this. So once again, I'm going to hit tab, type in ultra grain, hit enter. And I want to link the grain amplitude. So I'm going to reveal the controls, click the link, and choose opacity. And I might make the grain a little bit more obvious, so I'm going to just scale that by 2. Right. So now I want to come back and adjust my opacity, and I can do that quickly by clicking on View Driver Node. And that selects the vignette node, and I can quickly access opacity. So now when I change the opacity, the grain will increase and decrease. Very nice. So you can see how quickly we can link parameters together and create an entire look and control that just with one slider. But even more so, what we can do is we can decrease the amount of parameters that we show in the host to make it even more simplified. I'll show you what I mean. So with vignette selected, I'm going to uncheck host parameters, and I'm only going to show opacity. But opacity is not very descriptive, so I'm going to double click, and this is another new feature in 2023.5. I can rename parameters. So I'm going to call this tilt shift control. And I'm just going to deselect all of the parameters for ultra grain as well. And now under vignette, here in After Effects, which is the host that I'm using, there's one visible control. But of course, this is controlling all of those parameters that are linked to it. So if I just increase that, there we go. So full control over all those parameters, which is fantastic. So parameter linking in Builder allows you to create custom relationships between parameters. It allows you to simplify the controls that you see back in the host. And it also allows you to understand more easily what's important in presets that use parameter linking. Plus, you only have to keyframe one parameter inside the host, so that makes keyframing easier. Let's take a look at a few examples now of how we've used parameter linking in some of the modified presets and also some of the brand new presets. Now, in version 2023.5, we've actually reviewed all of the Sapphire Builder presets. And for some of them, we've actually created a version 2 where we've used parameter linking to make them more effective. And I actually even modified the look of some because looking at them with a fresh pair of eyes, I felt that they actually could look a lot better. And we've also created a number of brand new presets. Let's start by looking at a couple of examples where we've modified existing presets. This preset that I created, named Flames, uses Sapphire Aurora, and there's 3 copies of Aurora in this preset, so it's the perfect example of where parameter linking can be helpful. Now, there's Flame 1A, 1B, and Flame 2, and they all have the same start and end color. So all I've done is gone in and made the start and the end color the drivers, and just selected the other Sapphire Aurora nodes and linked those to that. So now when I come back and change Flame 1A, it's going to change all of the other ones. So I can get a consistent look across all of those colors when I change them. So that's a perfect example of when to use parameter linking. And another example here by our own Ben Brownlee is Twitchy Mind Control version 2. And it may look complicated here, but we have a couple of shake effects here and here, and you can see they have a lot of red in them. They're all being controlled by this top shake effect that Ben has renamed Tremors Controls, and you can see these are all green. And only a few of them are actually in the host. So when we go back into the host, we can see Tremor Controls, and these are the ones that Ben has decided are going to be the most useful for you when you're creating variations of this look. And I really like this spooky smeared look that this creates. For me, it's got that kind of Jacob's Ladder feel, if you remember that film. Very spooky. And here's an example of one of the new presets. This is called Caustic Cross. And in this one, I've used Wipe 4 Wedges. This is a transition. And you may not know, but you can actually use Sapphire Transitions within Sapphire Effect Builder. And for this, I've actually used 4 versions of Wipe 4 Wedges. And because this is a transition, it has a wipe percent value. And it would be crazy to have to go back into the host and keyframe 4 separate wipe percents. So what I've done is I've made Wipe 4 Wedges 1, the controller. You can see wipe percent is green, and also angles green because I've linked the angle. I've linked it to all 4 of these. And again, that means back in the host that I only have to keyframe 1 parameter. And there's also much less chance of breaking this look because if they're all separate effects and I change wipe percent for one, then it's not going to match with the other ones. So this keeps them all in sync. And here's another example. This one's called Caustic Portal. And you can see this also looks pretty complicated. What I've done here to make things easier to use is I've actually linked all of the effects that have a seed value up to this parallax strips effect. If I just scroll down here, you can see seed is green. And there's various effects in here. There's bokeh lights and texture flux. And these all have a seed value. So by linking them all together, changing just the thin strips seed, the parallax strips seed, changes all of the other seeds. So it's really easy to create variations of this look just by changing one parameter. Okay, so hopefully now you're excited to dive into Sapphire 2023.5. I certainly love using it. If you're new to Sapphire, be sure to visit boriseffects.com where you can learn more and download a fully functional trial version. For now, this is John from Boris Effects. I'll see you in the next tutorial.